Assalamu alaikum. Here we'll see how to do notification using Postman to iOS device. Okay, now here is my iOS device that's connected in my computer. So as I move this device, and we can see the reflection on computer itself. So this is the app that we are working on. Okay, now here we'll see two ways to send a notification from your from Postman and from Firebase to your app. So two ways will send notification. Okay, now the first one will use Postman to send a notification to your Flutter app. Once again, this is the app that we are going to send a notification to. Now here I have this body and I have this title. Okay, now here this is the device ID. Okay, and we also have a post method over here. So this is endpoint sent, this is endpoint to Google, and we are sending to a certain device. So this is the device ID, and this is the device that we are talking about. Okay, and basic notification information. In the headers itself, actually, we are sending content type as JSON and key. Now this key is the server key. Now, if you register your app, Firebase app, like this one, the one I did, so you would, let's see, you would come over here, project settings, and cloud messaging, okay? Now, over here, you will see the server key, and this is the key you need to put over here, okay? Of course, you need to use the key keyword for the key itself, okay? All right, so now we'll put our device over here and we'll see that we'll go ahead and click on this button, send, and hopefully we'll see messages there immediately. This is a title, this is a body, and this is the tag, this is the app name, okay? Now, we could do it one more time, and this time actually we'll change the information. Now here, this time, I would say this is a new message, okay? A new push notification, okay? Now I'll go ahead and hit, and hopefully we'll see that it shows up here. A new push notification, this is a new message, exactly this one. And over here we also see this, okay? All right, okay, now how to get this token, okay? Now if you have Flutter app and you're trying to push you're trying to push notification from your app, now definitely if it's iOS app, that's what I'm talking about. Now you will have this app delegate thing over here. Every iOS app, I mean, regardless, it's Flutter iOS app, React Native iOS app, they'll have app delegate. And over here, actually, you can get the token. So I'm using this function to get the token, as you see. So I printed the token and then I saved it. And as I use Postman, so I just put the token for this two. Okay, then it sends notification to this certain device. Okay, now we'll see how to send notification for from Firebase. Okay, all right. Now, of course, once again, this is my app, and over here I'll choose messaging. All right, and over here I'll choose new campaign notifications. And I'll say fast notification. Okay, notification body. All right, now we could do one thing. We could also put the token over here, but it's not necessary. And this is the old one, we don't need that. So it's not always necessary, okay? So unlike Postman, where you always want to post it to a certain device, but from the Firebase, it's not compulsory, so you can skip that part. Now here we'll choose our app, iOS app, and then here we'll choose this one. Next, And we can enable them. And over here, batch count. Batch count, I'll set it to 3. Now, what is batch count? Actually, this number is called batch count. Previously, I've used 2, but now I'm using 3. Okay, so hopefully, if I get notification here, I'll see 3. Okay, now what I'll do, I'll put it next to each other and I'll do publish. Okay, now with the Firebase notification, it's not guaranteed from Firebase backend that you will get notification, unlike Postman. Okay, so it may work, it may not work. Okay, now looks like it's not, we are not getting it, but we may get it. From my experience, it takes time sometimes, but not 100% guarantee. So as we wait for it, let's try another campaign. Now this time we'll try with the device token together. Okay, good one. We expect to see you. Now here we'll choose our device token. Okay, now device token, previously I have saved over here, so I'll just copy this one and then I'll go over here and I'll choose the token. I'll click on this and test and the next, and we'll select our app one more time. Oh yes, looks like we have seen one. Okay, this is the one that we have done just now. So it works sometimes, but it is slow. Okay, anyway, so we do next, and over here we do next, and we'll just publish, and this time we also expect to see it. Okay, all right, but once again, it might be slow. Okay, yeah, so this is the another one. Okay, this is actually the earlier one, so it, I think it just messed up, but you get the idea. But of course, this is coming from Firebase itself, right? And here we see the batch count is 3. So the idea is to be able to send notification on iOS, you have to have device token. It's better if you have, and of course you have to have your Firebase account.